Hi everyone, so today we are in the University of Arizona in the city of Tucson in the United States, and we have the great honor of interviewing Dr. Jane Giacomelli. So we'll take you on a tour with us.
I'm Gene Giacomelli. I'm the director of the Controlled Environment Agriculture Center at the University of Arizona. And I'm also a professor in the Agricultural and Biosystems Engineering Department. At the Controlled Environment Agriculture Center, we have faculty that are engineers and are plant scientists. We do educational programs that span the interdisciplinary nature of controlled environment agriculture for food crop production. We teach courses in hydroponics, in engineering of design of controlled systems, of integrated pest management. All of these we feel are important for ultimately the growers, but also for our students to gain the knowledge and experience in how to produce food in controlled environments such as greenhouses.
It was through aquaponics that I found the Controlled Environment Agriculture Center. There's an excellent course here in just intro to hydroponics, which is it's a basic overview. So it's some of the economics of managing a greenhouse, some of the pest management, the basics of nutrient solution, of even some of the very basics, like what are the materials that we build a greenhouse out of. But then the other 50% of the class is lab, but we all got to take care of our own 30 plants.
We also have research programs that help us develop the knowledge base, more information that we can then write about and publish, of course, but also prepare for short courses that we present to not students that are already at the university, but to the students of the industry, the growers, postgraduates that want to learn more about how to grow in a greenhouse or in a growth room or wherever you need to produce a food crop. And it's from these short courses that people come. They get some hands-on experiences. We also get classroom experiences. But also we can distribute this through the internet, and we offer some live presentations to those all over the world. To be successful, you have to have knowledge and experience. This just doesn't happen on its own. Although the biology of the plant does dictate a lot of what this will look like and taste like. But at the Controlled Environment Ag Center, our educational programs are focused on understanding the plant's needs, how it grows, how you can improve upon the quality of the product that comes out. And that's all about education. We feel that without that, our industry will be diminished, will be reduced, and limited, maybe is the best word. Vegetable production in the United States 100 years ago was market gardens surrounding the major cities. But during that time, the last 50 years, it's moved away from the cities. The valuable land became development. The farms have moved away. The transportation system was efficient to bring the food from California, Arizona, Texas, Florida. And they could be the larger farms, they became larger, could utilize the environment, the natural environment, for producing the product and ship it in. More recently, the interest in locally grown food and extremely fresh fruits harvested that morning has brought agriculture back towards the urban areas. So urban production agriculture and locally grown products began to experience a revolution, a resurgence, but it's using technology now of the 21st century. And a lot of that is directly involved with hydroponics in controlled environment systems.
with our internet access and our remote sensors and data collection, and also our webcam, I don't have to come up here to see what's going on. I can know from my house if the environmental conditions are the way we want them to be, if the plants are healthy.
The local foods movement has also brought the attention back to the consumer for demanding high quality vegetable products. And in doing so, it's opened up a whole new opportunity for young people who've never been involved with agriculture before.
Actually, for a while, I was studying Middle Eastern politics. I was studying poverty systems.
And it was really agriculture and engineering that pulled me out of that, in that I started looking towards solutions.
You don't have 100 acres in Iowa to grow your product, but you can have a small corner of a lot in a city or part of a building where you grow indoors with artificial lighting to create a small business. And we see the resurgence of young people coming into agriculture. Agriculture and food production is sexy now. It brings interest to people that never had the opportunity to know they had interest in it.
I never considered myself really much of a manual labor kind of a person, and my parents laugh at me now being a farmer because I was always pretty lazy as a kid.
I like it here. I like the plants, and it feels more like nurturing in the greenhouse situation than farming per se, because each plant we get it gets more my maternal instincts going. So I'm like, oh honey, what do you need?
And we love it because you bring them in, you give them experience, you let them work on tomato plants or lettuce plants, they see their product. They take ownership of it. And that will continue to create what we've had, I guess, in agriculture forever. The farmer, the grower, has a love for what they do, an appreciation for how hard it is to do it, but an appreciation for the success that they produce and then provide to society.
Yeah, I mean, I really like it. It took me by surprise how much I really like farming.
These young people now have never been on farms before, nor in agriculture, are having that opportunity to do that. And this is in part because of the local foods movement, urban agriculture, and the technologies of controlled environment agriculture and hydroponics.